You're listening to Ask an Economist from the Conference Board of Canada.
So this is a great question that kind of forces us to go back and dust off the old Econ 101 textbook. But let's start by answering the question of what is quantitative easing exactly? And I think we have to think about the fact that central banks all over the world essentially have the ability to print money. In fact, they can just print money, and they get that money out onto the system, out onto the market by purchasing assets. This is essentially what quantitative easing is. It's adding to the money supply in a very direct way, with the bank essentially purchasing, in many cases, they'll purchase government bonds, and that helps lower the yields or lower the interests on government bonds, be it at being at the longer range. So they'll purchase 10-year government bonds to try and lower interest rates at the very long end of the yield curve. Of course, central banks have the ability to lower rates at the short term or at the short end by simply lowering their target rate. Be it the Bank of Canada rate in Canada, or the federal funds rate in the U.S. and many others across the world. So will quantitative easing work this time is the question. And I think there's no doubt that certainly as the bank is purchasing, the Bank of Canada doing this for the first time, and we didn't resort to quantitative easing back in the 2008-2009 financial crisis where many other central banks did. So this is kind of new territory for the Bank of Canada, but it has forged ahead with quantitative easing, purchasing not only government bonds, but also corporate bonds and mortgage securities. So the bank has gone in an extensive way to try and essentially lower yields, lower interest rates to make money and credit available for lenders, but also to essentially add to that money supply and add to the liquidity in the market. In fact, both these measures kind of doing the same thing. So there's no doubt that it will work. It will have the effect, the intended effect of lowering interest rates, rates especially on the longer end of the curves, adding to the liquidity in the market and helping us get through this this crisis that we're living currently. I guess the question longer term is how do we get ourselves back out of this? And I think the bigger question, again, going back to the Econ 101 textbook, is will all of this liquidity, all of this extra money that's been injected into the system, will that not eventually lead to inflation? And certainly that's the relationship that you'll find in your textbooks, in your economics textbooks. We haven't seen that happen in the last decade. We didn't see it happen with all of the quantitative easing that happened in post 2008-2009 crisis, but it may be very well a risk in a post-COVID recovery world where we may have to, in fact, deal with a rising inflation. So for now, I think it's the right measure. It is effective, but of course, there may be some issues and problems related to this later on.